Alrighty. And we are back with the next game. Kenzil advances, and we have Scorber fighting. Very nice. Oh, come on. Be nice to each other. Yeah, that was an amazing game from Screwtape and Kenzie. I did focus a little bit more on Kenzie there, because Zurg was just all over the place. He was microing his roaches, playing Ring Around the Rosie. I think he was trying to spell something. It was funny. And they were being really BM with each other. They were doing, like, BM hatcheries. It was exciting. Definitely a replay worth saving. Okay, so we have Kenzie. Ooh, hello, cat. We have Kenzie the Cobalt Zerg starting in the top right position. Oh, Shattered Temple? I think so. Anyways, nice face. And we have Scorber the orange, Scorber the orange Zerg playing in the bottom left corner. This is kind of a cheese map, that is true. We have a drone scout heading out from Scorber already. Can I cat? Don't mess with my mouse hand! Can Silverlord spots that drone going in for the scout? Trying to keep him typing. Holy patrol path. He's going for gas. Both players are. I don't think there will be cheese. Gas is not usually indicated for cheese unless there is going to be some kind of sudden road crash. They both got a lot of workers. I don't see a thing here. Scorber, you brought this on yourself by claiming you're female. I'm sorry. I think the only females we have in our division is myself, Genova, and we had a recruit, Miss FX, that applied for StarCraft 2, but we haven't seen her since. So, don't know what happened there. Sorry, my cat is lonely. Yes, I know. We have a spawning pool going down for Scorber. Well, you know, he did pylon block. That was pretty epic. Took a while for the expansion to go down. Yes, he's a very cute kitty. Yes, I know! Yeah, so far it looks pretty identical. Scorber is going for Zerglings first, though, and Kenzie is still droning. Oh, he's going Banelings. Very nice. Both are getting speed and their queens out. It's gonna be pretty similar. Four lanes out already for Kenzie. Did not see those coming. Somebody was trying to get my attention. Oh, I know. We have a Baneling Nest going down. I see a Roach Warren going down for... Okay. I don't know why he's spamming. That's why he's spamming. Very nice. Why are you announcing your strategy? Yeah, he's giving the CD road forms. So, yeah. We have speedlings out from Scorber, just doing a quick scatter around, making sure there's probably no cheesy things going on, or he's just gonna go- Oh! Banelings in the fiery gates of hell! Yes! Hello, cats. Sorry, I did warn you guys at the start of these casts that my cat was looking at me. With these longing eyes for attention. and that he might interrupt. Oof. Yes. Yourself. And yes, I talk to him because I live alone and he's my only company. There he goes. That's it. Eat your food. Get fat. Rotoran and an evolution chamber going down for Scorber. I guess Kenzie was trying to freak him out by saying, oh, I'm going roaches. How about you? Just to see what he would do next. And now Scorber is responding with roaches of his own. And upgrades. So that's going to be interesting. Meanwhile, Scorber has 4 Banelings and about 6 Ling hiding in the Fiery Gates of Hell just waiting to do some damage. He is behind in supply. And about to be supply blocked. Meanwhile, Kenzie is getting his natural down with 6 Lings, or 6 Roaches, sorry, to guard it as he gets his creep spread down his ramp. Alright. Speaking of Roaches, Scorber has 8 Roaches coming up to the tower where he's got his Zergling just keeping an eye out. And 3 more on the way. It looks like he's got them just rallied up there. No, he's sending them up himself. So many roach. It's called the Fiery Gates of Hell on Live TV. And as much as that says about my casting, I watch them a lot. I've watched almost every single game they've casted since I started doing When Cheese Fails. Sorry about that. I'm gonna get blamed for this, but I'm not really a big fan of Tastosis. I know they're both really, really good pro players, and they have history, and they have a hell of a lot more working knowledge of StarCraft and StarCraft 2, than other people, like LagTV. But, I watch LagTV for purely entertainment value. Holy Banelings, these are gonna get owned! They do nothing against these roaches! Damn! FML indeed. Down that goes. That sucks. Okay, so Scorber is going back to his base. He's really behind in this match. Roaches just coming out for Scorber. No upgrades yet. Yeah, I didn't want to say anything, but that was starting to sound pretty BM. I tried to just take it in stride, although of course I'm not the one playing. Scorber's the one that's probably getting frustrated. Yeah, he's got a whole mess of roaches on his front doorstep. He's going to want to cancel his hatchery. There we go. Oh, snap. Uh-huh. Keep typing on your keyboard. I'm just waiting for this to upgrade. And Scorber's getting more overloads out because he knows he's supply blocked. He's got a lot of money floating because he's just been really defensive this game, really nervous. He doesn't know what strategy to pursue, because Kenzie has been freaking him out for most of the game. Yeah. He's got a lot of roaches in production here, though. Maybe he can get his army up? He's max food again, though. And he needs to get more overlords down now. Try and poke out at these roaches. Kenzie's just sitting outside his base, just mackering up, waiting. Just waiting for his moment. 3 extractors going down for him, as well as a lair. Meanwhile, Scorpus Gaming is Lair 2, so they're probably going to try an advanced tech. What did Zero do? Yeah, it's true. I think Kenzie is just psyching Scorber out for the most part. He's just telling him what he's gonna do and making him prepare for it, whether it's true or not. So this time, it's probably not even true. Nope, okay, never mind, there's a Spire. Meanwhile, Scorber is just going to turtle up, play a one base Zerg for a while, try and figure out what the hell he could possibly do. And he's getting his second gas, and his lair just finished. Hydralisk Den going after Scorber. Okay, so is that the direction he's gonna go? Yeah, if you get Hydras just shooting at them from the high ground, that'd be pretty awesome. And that would either force him to come in or pull away. Not bad. Oh, really? No, what? No! No, Scorber, why? Okay. Okay, I'm turning this damn thing off to get ready for the frickin' next game. Yeah.